In this video, we'll be taking a look at three MLB games happening on August 23rd, 2024, and providing you with free team picks and total picks for each one of those games, so six picks in total. Welcome back to Cash Out Sports, let's dive right into it. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe and to click the bell icon to get notified as soon as these videos get released, so that you have more time to plan out your bets as we provide these videos on a daily basis. I can guarantee that you'll have all the important information that you'll need on these three MLB games after fully watching this video. One more thing before we start, if you would like to gain access to our best exclusive sports picks to take your journey to the next level, then check out our Patreon in the link down below where we offer our best single picks, parlay picks, and much more. Now let's get started. St. Louis Cardinals versus Minnesota Twins. As we approach the weekend, baseball fans have plenty to be excited about, with a thrilling lineup of games on the horizon. One matchup that stands out in particular is the Midwestern clash between the Minnesota Twins and the St. Louis Cardinals. The Twins are entering this series with strong playoff aspirations, while the Cardinals are fighting to keep their postseason hopes alive, though their chances are dwindling. The Twins have been nearly unstoppable at home this season, boasting one of the league's best home records. In contrast, the Cardinals have struggled on the road, managing a lackluster 29-34 away from St. Louis. Offensively, the Twins have consistently put runs on the board, ranking sixth in the league, while the Cardinals have had a much tougher time, finding themselves in the bottom 10 in scoring. On the pitching front, both teams will be relying on young arms. The Cardinals' Andre Pallante has delivered a solid season and is expected to keep the game competitive, but Minnesota's David Festa has been on a roll lately, showing impressive form as he adapts to the major leagues. St. Louis is desperate to secure a playoff spot, but the road ahead is challenging. Their schedule puts them at a disadvantage, particularly after playing a taxing Thursday afternoon game following a late-night, extra-inning contest on Wednesday. This tight schedule could wear down their bullpen, especially if Pallante struggles on the mound. Meanwhile, the Twins had a day off on Thursday after finishing their series against the Padres, giving them an extra edge. Festa, who has been improving with each start, will take the mound for Minnesota. With a strong home record of .600 and a reliable bullpen, the Minnesota Twins' money line is our full game side pick. On Friday night, I'm leaning towards taking the under 8.5 total runs in the Twins versus Cardinals matchup. The Cardinals have had difficulty generating offense all season, ranking in the bottom 10 in scoring and continuing to struggle during their recent slump, having lost 7 of their last 10 games. While the Twins have a potent lineup, they've only managed to score more than 5 runs once in their last 9 games. On the pitching side, Andre Pallante has been effective for the Cardinals, especially on the road, where he's maintained an earned run average in the low 3s. Minnesota's David Festa has also found his stride, posting an impressive August earned run average of just 2.03. Considering the circumstances, under the projected total is our full game total pick. New York Mets versus San Diego Padres. On Friday evening, the New York Mets will face off against the San Diego Padres in the second game of their 4-game series at Petco Park. This matchup promises to be an intense continuation of the series, with both teams vying for crucial wins as the season progresses. In his lone start against the Milwaukee Brewers last season, Blackburn delivered an impressive performance, pitching 6 scoreless innings. On the other hand, Musgrove has had his share of difficulties when facing the Mets, accumulating a 2-5 record and a 4.84 earned run average over 35.1 innings pitched against them. The Mets have been dominant in recent encounters with the Padres, winning 5 out of their last 7 matchups, including a sweep in a 3-game series in New York earlier this season. San Diego's offense has struggled in these meetings, hitting just .197 with a .338 slugging percentage over their last 5 games against the Mets. Meanwhile, the Mets have been formidable on the road this season, winning 53% of their games away from home and ranking among the top 5 in several offensive categories, including 4th in slugging percentage with a .432 mark. New York's pitchers have also been in excellent form, posting a 3.2 earned run average over their last 5 games. In contrast, the Padres' pitching staff has had a rough time in front of their home fans, ranking 23rd in the majors with a 4.2 earned run average. San Diego's offense has also faltered at home, scoring 3 runs or less in 2 of their last 3 games at Petco Park. While I'm not fully convinced about the Mets' long-term prospects, I still have reservations about Joe Musgrove, and I believe the Mets have something brewing here. Although the Mets' bullpen remains a concern, Paul Blackburn has generally pitched well for his new team, and the Mets' offense looked sharp on Thursday. Given these factors, I'm leaning towards the Mets, especially when considering the value of the plus money in this spot. As I mentioned yesterday, this series is one where I'll continue to look for value in the odds. The San Diego Padres are currently on one of their hottest streaks of the season and are battling hard for a playoff spot. Simultaneously, the Mets have been mashing the ball offensively and are also in the thick of the playoff hunt. Both teams have a compelling case, so I see value in grabbing the more favorable price, which worked out for us yesterday. Therefore, the New York Mets money line is our full game side pick. In a start against Milwaukee last season, Blackburn limited the Brewers to just 4 hits and no runs while striking out 5 batters. Similarly, Musgrove has shown his capabilities by shutting out the Mets over 6 innings in his last start against them. In 4 of the last 5 matchups between these two teams, the total runs have stayed under the projected number, with only 10 runs scored in 2 of the 3 games earlier this season. The Padres' offense has been stifled by the Mets' pitching, managing 3 runs or less in 3 of their last 5 contests against New York. Likewise, the Mets' offense has struggled at Petco Park, scoring 2 runs or less in 4 of their last 5 games there, while batting a dismal .179 with a .244 slugging percentage. The Mets have consistently gone under the run total in 8 straight road games, scoring just 1 run or less in their last 3 games. Their pitching staff has done its part, limiting opponents to 3 runs or less in 4 of their last 5 games. Meanwhile, the Padres pitchers have also been stingy, holding opponents to 2 runs or less in 5 consecutive home games. Even if the Rays decide to go with a bullpen day, they will likely continue to rely heavily on their pitching. As I've pointed out before, the Rays lineup doesn't inspire much confidence, and 8 of their last 10 games have seen a total of 7 or fewer runs scored. I can only lean towards the under in this game. Both bullpens are stacked with strong arms, and I don't anticipate a high-scoring contest, even with Bobby Miller getting the start for the Dodgers. Los Angeles has only allowed 7 runs in the Mariners series, and in Miller's last outing, the scoreboard showed just 7 runs. Under the projected total is our full game total pick. San Francisco Giants vs. Seattle Mariners. An exciting interleague matchup is set for Friday night as the San Francisco Giants face off against the Seattle Mariners. Last season, when these teams met, the Mariners won 2 out of 3 games. This time, Seattle has the advantage of playing on their home turf at T-Mobile Park. Both teams are in desperate need of a win to boost their standings, making this a highly anticipated series opener. The big question is, which team will step up and secure the victory? Seattle's lineup should have a spark, especially after their manager's recent departure. Playing at home has been a strong suit for the Mariners all season, as they've maintained a winning record at T-Mobile Park. Facing Giants pitcher Hayden Birdsong, who currently holds an earned run average and FIP above 5, the Mariners find themselves with a favorable matchup. Additionally, San Francisco's bullpen has shown vulnerabilities, making them susceptible to a potential Mariners offensive breakout. When Luis Castillo is on the mound at home, he consistently delivers the ace-caliber performances that Seattle traded for. Remarkably, he hasn't allowed more than 3 runs in a home game since April 2nd, and it's unlikely that San Francisco's mediocre offense will change that trend. However, Seattle enters this series struggling, as they've fallen 5.5 games behind the Astros in the American League West standings. Despite their recent difficulties, the Mariners have played their best baseball at home, boasting a 37-26 record. On the other hand, the Giants have been lackluster on the road with a 27-36 record and will need to improve if they want to stay in the wild card race. Although Birdsong has shown promise earlier this season, his recent struggles raise concerns. Meanwhile, Castillo has been somewhat average in his recent starts, but Seattle's offense should find opportunities against Birdsong. Given the circumstances, the Seattle Mariners to win and cover the spread as favorites is our full game side pick. As for the total, the pitching quality in this game leaves room for offensive fireworks. Neither bullpen is particularly reliable, with San Francisco's ranking 22nd in WAR and Seattle's even lower at 27th. This could lead to shaky performances in the late innings. While Castillo has been strong at home, his 4.15 earned run average for the month suggests he's not invincible. Birdsong, on the other hand, has given up more runs than innings pitched this month. Given these factors, over the projected total is our full game total pick. That's all for now. So if you have any other games you would like reviewed, then leave a comment down below with the game you would like analyzed. Subscribe to our channel, leave a like on this video, and we'll get to it as soon as we possibly can. We would also love to hear your opinion on the picks presented to you in this video, whether you agree or disagree with them. So leave a comment down below and do let us know.